last time. And today what we are going to understand is Poisson's equations in the design. So this is the numerical part here. What is the numerical? This is again taken from the S.K. Gerg's book. What it states that in the previous example 11.1, this example is 11.2, the uncorrected percent residual pressure at C1, D1, E2, D2, C2, E3, D3 were all computed with the use of Poisson's charts. It is now desired to compare these pressure analytically using the respective formulas if the charts are not available. So certain students ask for chart that you provide as chart. So if charts are not provided and it is not asked that you solve it by using the charts, then you could solve this analytically without using charts. So let's see how we need to solve it. The problem is again the same. This weir is here having this configuration which we had seen in this previous example 11.1 S.K. Gerg, and this lastly we have drawn this line called hydraulic grade line where we have sorted out the head loss 158 to 152 here that we have seen. We have computed these here with the corrections computed using the charts. So we are going ahead with now with what? The equations, and when we are using equations, we call it analytical solution. It's not a graphical solution. Now, for upstream pile number one, the B, D, you remember, B is 57. This D is 6 meters. 154 minus 148. 154 minus 148, because we are calculating outside for D1. 6 meters, alpha is this. B by D is coming out 9.5. This we have done even for the charts. While using charts, we need value of alpha or 1 by alpha, depending upon the situation. Now, to compute this, the pressure F pi E, where is E? This pi E for such a case, refer this, is given by this equation. So equation is mentioned like this, 1 by pi cos inverse lambda minus 2 by lambda. Earlier we haven't used this lambda, where lambda is equal to 1 plus this equation are given here. Pi E just hold. Okay, let's see, compute this, these values. So we are picking up these equations from here, and we are not using chart this time. We are using these equations directly to calculate the value of these critical pressure points. And this is phi e 1 upon pi cos inverse lambda minus 2 by lambda, where lambda is equal to 1 plus root 1 plus alpha square by 2. If we put up the values, we get the value of lambda as 5.28. Now, if we replace this value of lambda, substitute the value of lambda into this equation, what we get, phi e is equal to 1 upon pi cos inverse this. And finally, what we are getting is 28.287, or percentage is 28.7. So the value of phi e, what is phi e here? Phi e in this diagram, when the pile is at upstream or at the downstream, and what we calculate phi is this, phi is this. So we should remember that this equation phi is this, and now we are interested in E1, D1 and C1. We know that the critical pressure here is 100%, and there is some reduction here and then some reduction over here. So let's go back here. This 28, so phi C1, the equation is 100 minus phi E1, phi E. Look at phi C1, the equation, analytical equation is this. Phi C1 is 100 minus phi E. If you could this is phi C1 and this is C1. So in our case, this point is also C1 here. So that is calculated as 100 minus phi E, and 100 to 70 is again 71 read out earlier from the charts. This is important. Now we are getting 71.3, and earlier we had 71% of the residual pressure at C1. Where is C1? This is C1. And from the charts, we are getting 71.3. So maybe this is precise or this is precise, but the difference is very marginal if we are using charts or the analytical method. Let's go back and check that how we calculated the C1 from the charts and how much it was. This was the charts based solution, and we have done here the correction at C1, then the, where is that value coming out? This is corrected C1 coming out as 74.38. This is the value we have done, and this is what read out of the charts, 71%. Similarly, if we look at the phi E1, then it is 100 minus phi D1, phi D. Where is that? phi d is 1 upon pi cos inverse. Phi d is this equation. This is for percentage. Directly if you multiply, you get percentage. If you keep 1, then you have to multiply by 100 at later stage. So what is d here? We have computed at C1, E1, D1, and this is what it reads, that this equation, this is wrongly written, something wrongly written here, phi E1, because if you look at here, this is 100%. This is 100%, this is 0 here, this is 0 here, 0%. We assume that pressure distribution, if our design is okay, then this is what it is going to be. It should be phi D1. This is correct. So 100 minus 19.9, and we are getting phi D1 as 100. What is phi D1? Phi D1 is this for us. And for this, the chart, we are reading this again phi D1, and this is D. And this equation is for phi D, means for this. Equation is for this, not for the upstream. So this is the equation for the downstream. And when we calculate for phi D1, then we have to subtract phi D from 100. And we are using the same formula here, 100 minus 19. This is the values we are keeping or substituting in the equation of phi D, which is taken from the cost loss. So the total phi D1 is coming out as 80.1. percent is against 80% readout earlier from the charts. This is noted, this should be noted. So this give you an understanding that both the methods given are comparable. They give us more or less similar output. Let's go further. Now we are switching over to the intermediate. There are only 3-4 slides today. I'm not going to bother you much the correction part, the 3 corrections we are doing for the slope, interference, and the slope, interference. And what was the 3rd? 3 corrections which were done with the charts, we are not going to do in the analytical. We'll only understand how the equations could be used. So this is for intermediate pile line number 2. This is the intermediate pile number 2. This is pile line. And now we are calculating the values here. And values here are E2, D2, C2. Here it should all be differing. If it is 80 here, something 70 here, then lesser value would come here, lesser value ultimately would raise to 0. So let's see this. This is intermediate pile. And for intermediate pile, we need to look up for this chart, which give us the intermediate position. Here we have, in our question, it is E2, D2, C2, but in Khosla's chart, it is mentioned as EDC again. And for equations, all equations are mentioned like this, E, C, and D, in terms of alpha 1 mentioned. And you know alpha 1, we have seen already. What is alpha and alpha 1? Delta and delta 1. So let's check it, that how it is being solved. So look at this equation directly picked from here, 100 upon pi cos inverse lambda 1 minus 1 upon lambda, this equation here, and likewise these equations here. So if I look at this lambda, then lambda here is not similar to the upstream and downstream pile, but it is differently taken. It is 1 plus alpha 1 square. Lambda is equal to 1 plus alpha 1 square plus root of 1 plus alpha 2 square by 2. Whereas alpha 1 is B1 by D. B1 is this distance. B1 is this distance. This distance. B1 is this distance. b1 by d, alpha 2 is b2 by d, b2 by d. b2 is the other side distance. This 57 in our case, so this 57 minus this distance. So that should be taken to calculate b2 by d for alpha 2 and b1 by d for alpha 1. And we substitute value of alpha 1 and alpha 2 here. And what is alpha 1? Alpha 1, this symbol only change. This is plus here and this is minus here for alpha 1. So these are the, delta 1 and delta. So delta 1 is this and delta is this. Only when while calculating, we change the symbol operator from plus to minus and we put up the values. D is the depth of intermediate pile. In our case, it is 154 minus 148 is equal to 6 meter. So that you could check from your given figure sketch that which are the values here. Similarly, this is the floor length upstream of intermediate pile is 16.4 and rest of the floor length is 40.6 to calculate the alpha 2. Now we are calculating alpha 1 as 16.46 we have seen is the depth we have taken and value of alpha 2 is 40.6 by 2, 6.7. If we substitute value in these two equations, we can calculate delta 1 and this only symbol changes. So this is 2.907 plus 6.843 divided by 2, 4 this much. And if we put up minus sign, then we get the negative value here is 1.968. Now substitute value of all this delta and delta 1 into the equation for E2, D2 and C2. So E2 is 1 by pi cos inverse lambda 1 minus 1 upon lambda. If you put up substitute these values here, what you get is this or 70.8%. This is the value is against 70% read out earlier from the charts. This is the value. Now we are using for 5D2 equation pressure, critical pressure at D2 point. Where is D2? Again, I show you the point because this is many a times confusing. This is D2, this is E2. This is E2. This is D2, this is C2. This is junction point of the pile and the wear flow. These points are end point of pile or the junction point of floor and the sheet pile. So here 70% and earlier how much was the value? C1 was 71.3 and now it is coming out a reduction of 1% or 2% approximately here. This is 71% only, 70.8%. Using this, the bottommost portion of the pile, we are getting reduction from 70 to 63, 7%. And now C2, again, if we are going further in the direction of flow, we are getting reduction as how much? 63 to 56. Almost 7% again, and earlier with the charts it was 56. So this is how we could calculate the pressures. Similarly, for the downstream pile, we have seen the equation that lambda here is again the previous one. For upstream and downstream piles, we do not use the lambda as mentioned in for the intermediate sheet piles. This is the lambda and lambda 1 for intermediate sheet piles, and this is the lambda for upstream and downstream. 1 plus root of 1 plus alpha square by 2. Alpha we know b by d. Here b is the full 57. We are not breaking into two parts as we broken it into two parts for the intermediate sheet pile. And we calculate the value of E2, D2 and C2. We do not do calculation, because we assume for C2, which is here, C2 is the C3 is the last point. So that calculation need not to be done, and the calculations can be considered at zero, as we have done in the while calculating the grid line. So these are basically three. These are misprint here to what we are doing downstream seed pile number three. So these points should be three. This is E3, D3. Let's check again to avoid confusion. This is E3, this is D3, and this is C3. Downstream sheet pile is this. We are calculating E3, D3, and C3. This is only zero. This is only 100%. This is 100%. We have seen on charts also. And we are seeking the value of E3 and D3. D3 is always the bottom of the sheet pile. So I go to the last slide. This for downstream sheet pile, this is 3 and this should be 3. So D2, the downmost point of the downstream sheet pile having pressure 25%. You could assume this is big. So depth of this, as we have seen, should be quite sufficient to have safe exit gradient at the end. So with this, I'm coming to the last slide of this divergent head work. Khosla, we have seen Blick, we have seen one numerical.